同学们好，欢迎来到跟我学汉语网络课堂。我是这门课程的主讲老师苏春，我来自中国广东外语外贸大学。我现在在俄罗斯乌拉尔联邦大学孔子学院教授汉语。今天我们要上跟我学汉语第一册第13课。My dear friends and students, welcome back to online course Learn Chinese with me. I'm the instructor of this course, Su Chun. I'm from Guangdong University of Foreign Studies in China. Now I'm teaching Chinese language and culture in Confucius Institute of Ural Federal University in Yekaterinburg, Russia. Today we are going to have lesson 13 in book 1, Learn Chinese with me.Before having the lesson, let me remind you, we finished the Unit 1 and Unit 2 in this Book 1. Today, we will do a brief revision of Unit 2, okay, from Lesson 7 to Lesson 12. We have learned all these structures and sentences. 他是谁?他是谁?我有好朋友,我没有好朋友。你有几张中文光盘?我有六张中文光盘。这是谁的钱包？钱包里有多少钱？他们在这里，他们不在这里。尤拉和安娜在哪里？我跟同学们在一起，安娜很高兴，王佳明也很高兴，我们都很高兴。你明白吗？很好，非常好。Okay, also we have learned some Chinese songs like 我的朋友在哪里?一二三四五六七,我的朋友在哪里?在北京,在上海,我的朋友在这里。And 生日快乐,祝你生日快乐,祝你生日快乐,祝你生日快乐,祝你生日快乐。Also, we learn 小星星，一闪一闪亮晶晶，满天都是小星星，挂在天上放光明，好像许多小眼睛。一闪一闪亮晶晶，满天都是小星星，对吗？ And also, we learn Chinese tongue twisters, two tongue twisters. The first one.一只青蛙，一张嘴，两只眼睛，四条腿。两只青蛙，两张嘴，四只眼睛，八条腿。Do you remember? 记得吗？ And also, a tongue twister with the numbers. 十四是十四，四十是四十。Okay? Also, we learn one.Actually, the first Chinese ancient poem in this semester. 一望二三里，里烟村四五家，亭台六七座，八九十枝花。Okay, I hope you understand. Now, let's review the interrogatives we have learned. They are so important to ask questions. The first one, 什么?What? 这是什么？这是什么？那是什么？你找什么？你找什么？吗？ Okay, it's the simple question word, right? Put it at the end. 这是钱包吗？那是书包吗？钱包 wallet, 书包 school bag. Who? 谁？谁 and 谁 both are all right. 这是谁？那是谁？你是谁？谁是你的好朋友？ And also we learn whose, 谁的？这是谁的钱包？这是谁的书包？几 ？How many？ 你有几张中文光盘？你有几个钱包？你有几个朋友？几 ？How many？ You must go with the measure word. 多少？哈哈，钱包里有多少钱？ Remember how much money? 钱包里有多少书？ How many books? 学校有多少老师？明白吗？ Now, let's check the homework in 12. Okay, copy the test and the new words. 今天是我的生日，我跟朋友们在一起，我们吃蛋糕，听音乐，大家都很高兴，我也很高兴。And also copy this.Characters with the same radicals. Okay, I hope you can have your own booklet. And fill in the blanks with the proper characters and complete the sentences. Let's do it. 今天我跟大家在一起。对了吗？我跟好朋友在一起。我很高兴。They look alike. 我们吃蛋糕，大家很高兴。One sound, two characters.大家一起听音乐，我们都很快乐，哈哈。One character, two sounds. Okay, I want you to write down the questions. 你叫什么？哦，你叫什么名字？我叫安娜。你多大？我19岁。你是哪国人？我是俄罗斯人。Actually, we haven't learned this.Question, right? 你是哪国人？哪 ？Which 国 ？Country 人 ？People? Which country people are you? 你找谁？我找苏老师。这是谁的书？这是我的书。里面有多少钱？多少钱？里面有100元钱。王佳明在这里吗？王佳明不在这里。你吃什么？我吃蛋糕。音乐好听吗？音乐很好听。今天是谁的生日？今天是我的生日。你和谁在一起？我和朋友在一起。伏特加好喝吗？伏特加 vodka， 嘿嘿 famous。伏特加非常好喝。Okay, so that's the end of checking and revision. Let's begin the new lesson. 现在上课，我们现在上第13课。The title of 第13课 is 你多大？你多大？ Let's look at this dialogue between 佳明 and 尤拉。尤拉，你多大？我17岁。The first question and answer. 你学不学开车？ Second question.当然，你呢？你是不是16岁？对，我16岁。你明白吗？Some new words. Let's look at this. 多大？多大 ？How old 啊 ？How old? Okay. 岁 ，the year or the, means the age. 开车，开车 ，drive the car, drive the vehicle. 当然 ，of course. Okay.好，尤拉，你多大 ？How are you, 尤拉 ？How old are you, sorry? How old are you? 我17岁。啊哈，明白吗？岁 ，years. I am 17 years old. 你学不学开车？啊，你学不学开车 ？Do you learn or not learn driving the car? 当然，当然。Конечно. Of course.你呢？你呢 ？How about you? 呢 is a new word, but it's not in its vocabulary list. I will tell you, okay, later. 你是不是16岁？是不是？学不学？嗯哼。Are you or not? 啊哈 ，16 years old. 对 ，right, yes. 我16岁。明白吗 ？Okay, so let's.Look at the first sentence, the first question. 尤拉，你多大 ？How old are you, 尤拉 ？So 多 ，we have learned 多，多少 ？We learn 多少钱 ？Remember？ 嗯哼，多少钱 ？Yes, but now is 多大？多大？大 is old in age now. How old are you? How old are you? And the answer is 我17岁。岁。Actually, how old are you? You have 4 ways to answer. The first one is only the number, 17, 17, or 17 岁, 17 years, without I. Or 我17, 我17, without the years, 我17岁, okay? That's pronoun plus number and the years. Okay, 我17岁, 岁 is a new word, please look at it. He has the complicated one, the traditional one. So it compels the mountain on the top and this sea, this character here is sea means the sunset. Okay, please compare these two characters. They have the same radical at the bottom. But here's double sea and this is a shan mountain. Pay attention to this mountain stroke order. 先中间后两边 first, right, the middle stroke, and then here. And 多大? Just now, how old are you? 多大? Also, you can say 多少岁? 多少岁? It also means how old are you? 多少岁? Okay, so we have two ways to ask for the age. One is 多大? 多少岁? 你多大?你多少岁? Okay, you can ask your classmates about their age, okay, with these two sentences. The answer is, 我十六岁,我十七岁,我十八岁,明白吗? Okay, now let's turn to the next set, question. 你学不学开车? First of all, let's look at this 学不学. It's a V, not V. V is verb. Verb, not the question. It's a question.It's a special pattern to form a question or confirm something without the interrogative word. It's a very special pattern in Chinese. Okay, 学不学? Do you learn or not? Okay, do you learn 开车? Remember, 开车 is the driving the car, driving the vehicle. So that it means, do you learn driving the car or not? So you can see, 你学不学汉语?Do you learn Chinese language or not? Do you learn 打球? 你学不学打球? Play the balls. Do you learn play the ball? 你是不是学生? Are you a student or not? So please remember this V not V question. In Chinese we call it 正反疑问句。正反疑问句, however, it has not the interrogative word. So,It's a special question, a special pattern to raise a question without the question word. 他是不是老师 means 他是老师吗? Ma is an interrogative word, right? But if you do not have ma, you can say 是不是, 是他是老师. So you can see, 他是不是中学生? We can use 是不是 to raise a question. 是他是中学生。他们是不是好朋友?他们是不是好朋友?是 or 不是? Okay, so verb not verb equals verb 吗? Let's look at this. Do you study Chinese language or not? We can say 你学不学中文? Okay, repeat it. 学不学中文? Or just say 你学中文吗?你学中文吗? The meaning is the same, but different structure.你打不打篮球?你打不打篮球? So it means, 你打篮球吗?你打篮球吗?明白吗?你有没有朋友?啊,有没有? So you see, 打, we, 不, we, 不 is for the other verbs. However, only one verb, 有, you have to use 没. 你有没有朋友?你有朋友吗?没,有没有? Negative form of 有 is 没有.So we can use this phrase, okay, the pattern to change this, make a sentence, or make a question. 是不是?你是不是中国人?你吃不吃蛋糕?你听不听音乐?你喝不喝茶?喝不喝咖啡?你打不打篮球?你有没有朋友?你有没有汉语书?Now, okay, just now we learned 学不学. Now, here, 开车 is a new phrase for us, right? 开, 开 means to drive. Actually, 开 has many meanings. In this phrase, means drive. 车 is the vehicle, okay, or the car. Any car is called 车 in Chinese. And 车 is written like this, with the wheels in the ancient time. Please compare these two characters, 车 and 东. They are not the same. 东 remember 安东.安东, 车 is the vehicle, 安东 is the name of the student. 东 actually means a direction, the east. 开车 driving the car. 安东，你学不学开车？ This is the question. Okay, in the test, 学啊。If you say yes, do not say yes. You say 学啊。Repeat the verb. 我学开车。安东，你开不开车？ And 开 also means drive. It's a verb. 开不开？ Vid not v. Do you drive the car? Do you learn driving the car? Do you drive the car? 开呀、啊，开呀、啊。So repeat the verb.你学开车吗？啊哈 ，we can change it with a 吗 ，right？ 学不学？你学开车吗？学呀、啊，我学开车。你开车吗？开，我开车。Understand？ So we can change 学不学、开不开 into 学吗？开吗 ？So it's very important for you to understand this pattern. Okay, it's a pattern to ask question and to form to confirm something without.Interrogative word. 你学不学？你开不开？ Now I want to give you more phrases with 开. We have another phrase 开心，开心。Okay, 心 the heart. Be happy, pleased, and be glad. 开心。And 开学 we learn 学 right? 学啊、students school. 开学 means begin the semester. So you see, 开车 means drive the car. 开心 be happy. 开学 begin the semester, and then.Oh, 开门 open the door. 请开门，请进，请开门 open the door, please. 明白吗？ Okay, so let's do some exercise, okay, to make you understand it better. Use 开车，开门，开心，开学，填空 Fill in the blanks with these proper words, okay? 王佳明，你学不学开车？家里有人吗？家里有人吗？请开门。Okay, is anybody at home? Please open the door. 今天学校开学，学校开学。The school begins the new semester today. 我很开心。I'm so happy. So, these are the examples to show you that one character, okay, it has many meanings when it combines with the other characters.开车开门开学开心 OK, let's go on 当然当然你呢你是不是十六岁当然 means of course sure absolutely OK, let's look at this 当 first also I want to mention this stroke inside not inside in the center OK, yes first and then second this comes from 小小字头 OK, so it must beit must follow this stroke, okay? 小 but hook without the hook, only 竖小 is 竖钩 okay? 然 oh, it's a little bit difficult for us to write this radical okay, so first of all, this is a new radical at the bottom, okay? Means fire, it's 火 fire.Here, year, we know it, right? The moon, the month, and also 全 全 is 全 means the dog. So, the moon, the dog, and the fire, it means 燃 燃当然 of course. Okay, so let's continue. 你呢你呢你是不是十六岁啊、是不是 we just love it, right? 是不是 is aV not V pattern to ask question. N is also a very special verb. It can be used as kind of auxiliary particle. Also, it can be a question, be an interrogative word. 你呢 means how about you? How about? Of course, how about you? 你是不是十六岁 Are you 16 years old or not?The answer, the last sentence, 对 sure, yes, 我十六岁 So, 对 can be used as yes. So, there are several ways we say yes. First one is 是 答 yes, correct, sure. And then 当然当然 absolutely, absolutely, okay? Now, let's review the test, We finished explaining this dialogue.尤拉，你多大？我十七岁。你开不开？你学不学开车？当然，你呢？你是不是十六岁？ 对，我16岁。你明白了吗？你多大？ Ask for the age. Okay? So here I want to mention here. 我16岁。我十七岁，我十六岁。These two sentences, okay? We call these two sentences a kind of special name sentence with the nominal predicate, because it do not, it has no the predicate. Use this nom, noun phrase as the predicate. Actually, if you say 我有十七岁，我是十六岁， both are alright.So, these nouns, phrases, or pronouns, numerals can be the predicate in the sentence. It is used to tell the time, age, place, nationality, and the appearance in a spoken language. It's okay, okay, in the spoken language. Now, let's do more practice to understand the test better. Kasha, 你多大？我十七岁。你学不学开车？当然，你呢？我十五岁，我不学开车。啊，当然，sure，不学，no. And we can change these names and also the years, and also we can ask different people, okay? For example, 我罗家，你多大？我十六岁，你学不学开车？当然，你呢？我十五岁，我不学开车。Okay, we can replace the names and the ages. Now, look at this dialogue without 拼音。尤拉，你有没有好朋友？明白吗？当然 ，of course. Or you can say 当然有 ，because you can repeat it, 有 the verb. 你学不学开车？当然 ，or 当然学 repeat the verb. 你吃不吃蛋糕？当然，当然吃。Okay, 当然 means yes, of course. Now, I would like you to listen a dialogue, okay, and try your best to write down the 拼音 I'm reading. And also try to understand the dialogue and answer the questions. How old is the boy? How old is Andong? Do they learn driving car or not? Okay, listen. Andong, 你多大？我十六岁，你呢？我十七岁。今天是我的生日，你学不学开车？我当然学。你学不学？我不学。明白吗？ Don't worry, okay? You can pause and you can check it later. Okay, also I'd like to show you another dialogue. 你是不是十八岁？ You can say 是 or you can say 对。Remember, 对 correct, 是 yes. 我十八岁。你是不是十九岁？不是，我不是十九岁，我二十岁。你学不学开车？当然。你呢？你呢 ？How about you？ 你学不学开车？学 ，repeat the verb。我也学开车。明白吗 ？OK。I would like to give you more information about Chinese culture, okay? How to ask the other's age in a polite way. Just now in the dialogue, we say 你多大？你多大？ Actually, 你多大 is used to ask the age for your classmates, your peers, and the young men or the little kids, okay? However, okay, if you asked the other's age, okay,in 你多大 all the time, it's okay, it's the most convenient sentence, most shortest, simple question. You can ask 你多大 to any people at different age, like the little girl, okay, this young girl, and this adult, and this old man and lady. However, okay, we have another a sentence, a question to ask the children under 10. Just 几岁？几岁 ？How many years? The same. 几岁？他几岁 ？For the little kids. 他几岁？他四岁。他几岁？他五岁。And you assume these kids, they are not older than 10. You can use 几岁。啊，多大 is for anyone, but 几岁 for the little kids. And also, if you want to ask somebody who are elder than you, you cannot use 你多大。It's better use 您多大。Remember, we have this 您 and respectable you, right? 您 respectable you. 请问 ,remember 请问啊 ,please,、can I ask? 请问您多大 ?Oh, 请问您多大岁数岁数 just now 岁、uh-huh. And you put 数 at the end. 岁数 is better. Oh, 您多大年纪 is more polite. More polite, okay? Oh, we have a very special typical expression for asking the old person when they are very old in 16 or 60 or 70 years, more than 60, okay? Then you can ask them, 老人家老 oh, 人 people, 家 is a kind of 老人家 means you can use this greeting to address the person like your grandpa, grandma, this elderly person, okay? Dear sir, 您高寿啊高很高兴 but he says 高寿高 means high.Shou means age, your high age. How is your high age? How old are you? In a very polite way, in a very traditional Chinese way. 您高寿啊？我七十岁。So we can say, how to ask elderly for their age in a polite way. We can say, 请问您多大? Rather than 你多大。您多大岁数？您多大年纪？ Or 您高寿啊 ,Wendy?You see this elderly person, they are in the 60, at least 60, okay, at least 70, use 高寿. So we can say that when you ask the little kids, you can use two questions, 你多大?你几岁? Okay, and for the young man, elder, you can say 你多大? When she is at the same age with you, you can 你多大? When he's older than you, 您多大?您多大? Okay, and for the old man, You can say, 您多大年纪?您多大岁数?哦,您高寿啊? Okay? 你多大 is very simple to anyone, okay? But when you learn better, I hope you understand, you are aware, okay, these differences. So, let's see. She's, 她六岁,她六岁,你多大?你几岁?她十八岁,你多大?他三十二岁，您多大？请问您多大？六十五岁，您多大年纪？您多大年纪？他七十岁，您高寿啊？老人家，您高寿呀？明白吗？嗯哼。So these are the ways we can ask for their age in a very polite way, in a very good manner. Now. I would like you to do the interview to your classmates, okay? However, we cannot do it in here. We will do it in our classroom, okay? The questions are, 你叫什么名字? Interview your classmates. 你是学生吗?你多大?你是不是二十岁?你有朋友吗?你有几个好朋友?谁是你的好朋友?你的朋友在哪里?你的朋友多大?明白吗? Please get ready, okay? You will ask these questions to your classmates. Okay, let me go back to this new word we learned today. We learned five new words, okay? 车岁当然呢 I supplied it for you. Also, in this test, there is a table. This is a new radical for us. It means fire. Three drop of water means water. Four drop means fire. And also we learned this already. 对，谢谢你 right? 月, the moon, and 娇笑 Review them from time to time. Now, let's turn to this part. It's a Chinese song. actually it's a French song. How we translated from French to Chinese. We have our own Chinese version. 两只老虎. Now look at this. I will read the lyric for you. 两只老虎，两只老虎跑得快，跑得快。一只没有耳朵，一只没有尾巴。真奇怪，真奇怪。两只老虎 ，two tigers. Okay, so it's a song. 两只老虎，两只老虎跑得快，跑得快。一只没有耳朵，一只没有尾巴，真奇怪，真奇怪。明白吗 ？You can find this song in the internet, but I want to emphasize the.Very important phenomena, in Chinese grammar, M and N. Not only the music, 不是单单是音乐哈，是我们的语法 Numeral, measurer, and noun. 之 can be used to the can be used to refer the animals. 两只老虎，两 remember 两二二两 is used before the measurer. 老虎 two tigers.In English, only two tigers. In Chinese, 2只 tigers. 两只青蛙，一只青蛙。Remember, 一只青蛙，一张嘴。So we have this kind of MM phrases. So, 两只眼睛，一张嘴，两条腿，四条腿，两只耳朵，一条尾巴，只张条。Okay, we use different measure to our body parts. Pay attention.Okay, the measure is the difficulty of learning Chinese. 真奇怪，真奇怪，真真 means really, really strange. 奇怪 means strange, really strange. 真 is an adverb. Okay, so I want to put these phrases and see whether you understand. 真好 really good. 真好吃 really delicious. 真好听 really.Pleasant to hear, really beautiful. 真好喝 really delicious. The drink, 喝 means the drink, okay? 真高兴 really happy. 真快乐 really pleased. 真多 oh, really many. 真少 really few. 真小 really small. 真大 really huge. Okay, now let me make a summary for today. We have learned how to ask the others age, right?The most important one is 你多大 Very simple to ask any people in different age. Also, you understand 你几岁 The difference between 你多大 and 你几岁你几岁 is only to ask 你几岁 is used to ask the children under 10. Also, we have different ways to ask the others in a polite manner. 请问您多大Respectable you. 您多大年纪？您多大岁数？您高寿啊？Try to remember this. Also, we learn a very important pattern. V not V. Okay, it's a special pattern to form a question or confirm something. 学不学开车？ Okay, it can be like the 你学开车吗？ Equal the meaning.Are the same. And also we learn more phrases with 开 such as 开车开心开学开门 Yes, we have different ways to say yes, 当然对是 Okay, in this dialogue. Also we learn very important radical fire, 4 dot fire at the bottom. 寸 is inch, 月 moon, 交 cross.两只老虎，两只老虎跑得快。Okay, please listen to the song. You can find the song in the internet. Homework here. Copy the test, please. Copy the new words as usual. And also, I hope you can do this exercise. Turn this question, into V not V pattern questions. Okay? 有吗？有没有？学吗？学不学？明白吗？ Also, Turn the V not V question into mark question. 他是不是苏老师？他是苏老师吗？明白吗？ fill in the blanks with the proper words. With 开，开车，开门，开心，开学。If you don't know, go back to the video. Also, answer the questions in Chinese according to your own situation. Copy these lyrics and try to sing the song. 两只老虎，两只老虎。Finish all the exercises in the test in the lesson 13, okay, in the workbook, please. Okay, now, 现在下课，同学们再见。